Now, what happens is you're calling a pet barn, you're calling like a pet store this morning,
right? Yeah.
And what you're trying to do is convince them that you would like a pet ibis. Right? Okay. Every time they say to you, no, we cannot get you a pet ibis, that will happen. God. There you go!
So what am I going to say when I'm getting electrocuted?
You have to come up with that yourself.
This is CFM's Crazy Call.
Pressure test.
Pressure test.
Pressure test.
Pressure tests.
Your time starts now.
Good morning, this is Craig speaking. How can I help you?
Yeah, it's Michael Feathers here, Craig. I'm just giving you a quick call. I'm just interested. I've got an aviary at home. I'm just interested in collecting some birds.
Okay, yep.
Yeah, what do you have there?
Are you interested in a particular species?
Well, I'm interested in big birds now.
Big birds?
Yeah.
Like yep.
The last 12 months I've been fascinated by ibis.
Ibis?
Yeah.
Okay.
So do you have any of those?
No, we're actually... we're actually not allowed to sell birds like that.
Okay, are you able to maybe get them in?
Ibis? No. I've never heard of anyone keeping ibises as pets.
Is there a reason why that you don't have them there?
Like, we deal with parrots. Like, parrots are sort of our forte.
Is there any way that you could train an ibis and get one in? Like, is there a law against it?
Well, yeah, there would be a law against it. Technically, we wouldn't be able to sell it. But, you know, from a younger age, any bird can be trained. So if you wanted to do that, if you're interested in purchasing an ibis, that's out of our field completely. We deal with parrots. So, we're not really allowed to sell them. So.
I'm sorry. I've got an infliction. I have a thing where I'm just not under complete control at the moment.
Oh, that's okay. Yep. So what larger birds we carry at the moment? We have rosellas.
Yes, they're not big enough.
So that's probably our biggest bird at the moment: rosellas and superb parrots, and also alexandrines.
All right. So there's no chance at an ibis.
No, sorry.
All right. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm still here. Yeah.
Yeah, Craig.
Craig, we have to let you know that it's Paul Gale from CFM and Moira and Bags.
It's actually a crazy call.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh.
Every time you've been saying that you cannot get him in an ibis, we've been giving him electric shocks. Craig, I am so impressed that you have done such a great job putting up with Gailey, who has
you are dead.
Electric shock strapped to his arm.
It's not that bad, is it?
Yeah.
No worries.
Craig, you're amazing, and your knowledge of birds is just second to none.
Oh, thank you.